Hello everybody, I'm Sneaksy Gamer, and welcome back to Diablo 2 Lord of Destruction. Now in the last episode... Sorry about that. In the last episode, I cleared the outer steps out here, and I made my way just a little bit into the Plains of Despair. This one I intend to hopefully clear the Plains of Despair. First, before I can clear it, I need to make my way back over to it. That is an exceptional weapon. Hopefully that'll be worth a fair amount of gold at least.
I am overburdened.
Already in my inventory. Okay. Now, I had said in the last one that I wasn't going to go around the edge to get there, but I got to thinking, going around the edge, I won't have as much resistance as just running straight through the middle, and it's still a pretty short run over there, so that's why I am taking the edge rather than just going straight through the middle of the area. Now... Israel is out here somewhere. Try to fun fight. See, the thing with Israel in this one is he's not that strong. He just takes a shitload of hits to kill. Like, way more than he should. He's got more life than Diablo does in this one. You've got to hit him more than you have to hit Diablo. Which is just insane. course, because I've got it on... I've got that thing set to 4 players. Sorry about that. Because of that, he's gonna be even tougher. He's gonna take even more hits than he normally would. Come on, draw them back here a bit, please. Can somebody hit me with cold? So someone's cold enchanted over here.
Overburdened.
Nobody's gonna drop a healing potion for, or a greater healing potion for me.
I can't carry anymore.
Okay then. Israel appears to be related to these things. He seems to be a form of one of those. And I'll know when Israel's... I'll be able to tell when he's there because he's got this weird glow around him. So I don't have to actually see him to know he's... coming, because if he's on the edge of the screen, I'll see that glow, and I can tell by that that Izul is over there. Oh, jeez.
I am overburdened. I can't carry anymore.
Did I have that I needed to identify still? Oh, that jewel, that's right.
Greetings.
Now, hopefully this is worth something good. I think I'm gonna start keeping the chipped gems again. Because I don't need to put potions into my stash anymore. There will be no point in keeping the super ones because I can't even buy those until the final difficulty, if I remember correctly. Which means I would just be stuck with them here. not stuck with them, I wouldn't be able to get more of them easily enough to rely on using those. Dropping a lot of scrolls of identify and scrolls from Town Portal today, aren't they? That's just weird. They don't always drop that many scrolls, do they? Or do they, and I just don't notice it? There's no way they drop this many usually. No way. Bit of a headache, that's not good. Thinking. I'm thinking I might just go in here and see if I can find the waypoint real quick. Then I will have the waypoint here so that in the next one if I didn't have time to make it back to here or if I didn't have time to make it through all of that place and then back and into here to find the waypoint in this episode, I would end up having to run all the way through both of those to get back here. There we go. But now I've got the waypoint here, so that way I can just use the waypoint in the next episode rather than having to run through the whole area again. Why am I still picking up scrolls? Just habit, I guess. Thankfully, Israel doesn't have any minions, so it's just him that we fight. Unless I've got other enemies on my ass when I run into him, which is a possibility. that glow that I was talking about. Yes, that life bar is moving, but it's not moving much. This is one time where this might actually be better to use. This is what I mean by he's tough. He's not that strong damage-wise, he takes a hell of a lot of hits to kill. Don't get me wrong, if you're reckless, you could get killed by him, but typically, I don't think I've ever been killed by him. It's just... I don't know. It just feels like I'm smacking a brick wall or something. There we go.
Soul stones and how to corrupt them. It was I who helped the Prime Evils mastermind their own exile to your world. The plan we set in motion so long ago cannot be stopped by any mortal agency. Hell itself is poised to spill forth into your world like a tidal wave of blood and nightmares. You and all your kind are doomed.
Okay. Oh, thanks, buddy. That's the exceptional version of the javelin that we saw before, way back at the beginning. Quest log, C-Tyrael for reward.
Thank you, hero, for putting Iswald's tortured spirit to rest. May the light protect you and the powers of heaven shine upon your path. But if what you tell me is true, then I fear that we have been played for fools all along. Iswald helped Diablo and his brothers trick me into using the soul stones against them. Now the stones' powers are corrupted. With the combined powers of the Soul Stones under their control, the Prime Evils will be able to turn the mortal world into a permanent outpost of hell.
Not if I have anything to say about it, they won't.
Greetings.
And I got a skill point for it. Oh, I got 2 skill points for it. Whirlwind is a cool one. I've never really used it that much in this game, though. If I remember correctly, it's a lot slower in here than it is in Diablo 3. Pretty sure these ones are better. Okay. Well, Israel didn't take too terribly long, but he did take a bit longer than I would like. He always does, though. Now, let's go back out there and
even fallen angels deserve freedom.
Yeah, that's Whirlwind. But you deal decreased damage when you use it, so I don't really see a point in using it unless I can get it leveled up to a point where you don't lose much damage with it. That's a nice little increase from that one. Command that I use to change the difficulty to increase the players, basically. That's something I kind of wish was in Diablo 3. Because I like to play Diablo 3, but I prefer to play it solo. And solo, you get to a point where you can't really make a whole lot of progress anymore after a while when you're playing solo. I mean, if you keep just going up and up and up and keep pushing up through higher and higher greater rifts in Diablo 3, I suppose you could continue to gain more experience and it wouldn't really make that big of a difference, but eventually you kind of get to a point where you can't go any higher and you're not getting enough experience to level up anymore. I've had that happen a few times, and that's where I would like to have something like that in Diablo 3, because then I could make it a bit more difficult for myself and still be able to play solo. Or I suppose I would like it if they added a higher difficulty level in that game, which I I have a feeling they will eventually. They'll add more difficulties to Diablo 3. Maybe not, but I'm hoping they will at some point. But that's not even this game. That's a totally different game. So I should probably not be talking about it too much. Just kind of speaking my mind here.
I can't carry anymore.
They're dropping way more scrolls than they normally do. It's just ridiculous. Something that I particularly like about this one, you can, as opposed to the first game, you can go back and redo areas that you've been in, and you can fight bosses and stuff over again. Like, if I wanted to, I could go and do a run through the catacombs and go and fight Andariel again. I mean, at this point, I wouldn't get that much experience from her, but that is a possibility. I could go back and fight Mephisto again if I wanted to. Which, if I remember, I might run back to go through Travancore and fight the Council again at the end of this episode, just because I could get some good items from them. That's way more than they usually drop for scrolls.
I am overburdened.
Might as well just go into town.
I can't carry anymore.
Greetings.
Neither of those were worth much at all. Okay, well. I just saw something highlight when I did that. Guess not. saw red lettering is from showing the name when I came back into this place. It was showing the name of the place, and I just saw the red lettering out of... cut out of the corner of my eye. I just caught red lettering up above, and I was thinking it was the red letters from the targeting the corpse, but it wasn't. I'm getting quite a few gems in this episode, that's nice. Too bad that I don't really need gems. We have a use for them. I mean, I'm sure I could find a use for them, but... but I don't have anything I particularly need to use gems for at the moment. Excuse me. Sorry, my voice was kind of going out there. These things are wimpy. They only take a couple of hits to kill, usually. And they don't really attack, but when they do attack you, they barely do any damage. I just don't understand why they're even in the game, honestly. I don't see what their purpose is. What do they give me for experience? Not a whole lot. Say that, I mean, like, not much activity, not no sound. How'd I miss that before? I wonder if my mercenary killed something there while I was fighting something else, and that's why I didn't see it. As I was saying, I seem to be getting a lot of gems in this episode. Like, way more than usual. That appears to be everything out here. But yeah, I do have enough time. I can go and see if I can take out the council, the High Council in Travancoligan, and see if I get any good items from them. Now, this is something that I would actually do in my own on my own in a game, I would actually come back and fight these guys multiple times just to get items from them. I have done it many, many times. Can't just run straight in there because I'd die if I did that. I gotta be a little cautious.
Can't carry anymore.
Nice. You just had to go up and get too close, didn't you? Even if I don't get good items, I'm getting a lot of items.
I can't carry anymore.
I may not get some real good items, but I'm getting a lot of magic items. And that's good too.
Overburdened.
Isn't there another one? Huh, guess not. I thought there was another one. Okay. Fine by me. So I didn't get anything particularly good this time, but I did get quite a few magic items.
Greetings.
I can sell off.
Good to see you again.
As I was saying, this is something that I would actually be doing in a game myself. I do it multiple times on my own, but for the sake of the video, I'll just do it once. Now, right? Yep.
Okay. Let's get back over here and grab more items.
I am overburdened. Good to see you.
Then go and sell the rest of these items.
Hello.
Dang. I would have liked to have gotten another set item or something, but oh well.
I can't carry anymore.
This is good too. Ah, damn it.
Stay a while and listen. Yes?
Then in the next episode, I'll be continuing on farther into Act 4. Plus one cold damage. That's not a whole lot. Here.
Hail to you, champion.
And of course, it's doing that crap again. I really don't understand why it's doing that. Please. Please be nice. I'd like to get something useful here. That doesn't seem like it's gonna happen. Anything else, do I? Nope. Okay, well, I guess let's get a potion. I guess that's it for this episode. So thank you everybody for watching. I hope you enjoyed. And as always, I will see you in the next episode. Goodbye.